Today is our introduction into exponents. Now, not long ago, I talked to you about repeated addition in math. And I said mathematicians really want an easier way to do repeated addition. And so they came up with something called multiplication. So if I had 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, it takes way too much time to actually write that. So they took whatever's being repeatedly added, 2, and how many times it was repeatedly added, we multiplied by 4 to get 8. Well, the same concept holds for exponents. Now, the difference is the exponents deal with repeated multiplication. So if I had 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, it takes way too long to write that out. So mathematicians said, how can we make this easier, but it has to look different than multiplication? So they came up with this idea of exponents. And whatever is repeatedly multiplied, that is called our base. So in this example, 2 would be our base. And the number of times it's repeatedly multiplied, that is our exponent, which we sometimes call power. So since I have 2 multiplied 4 times, I do 2 to the 4th power. And notice they equal the same thing. So, specifically, if we take a look at a whole number example, that's the easiest for us to do. So if we had 8 to the 3rd power, we would say that's 8 times 8 times 8, because it's repeated multiplication. Well, if I go to solve this, I'm going to do the first 2 8s first. So 8 times 8 is 64, then 64 times 8 is 512. So, if we evaluate 8 to the 3rd power, it equals 512. Now, notice our answers get enormous in a very short amount of time. But we don't have to just deal with whole numbers, we can also deal with fractions. So, what if I had 1/5 to the 4th power? Well, it simply means 1/5 times 1/5 times 1/5 times 1/5. Well, again, I'm going to break it down 2 at a time. So, 1/5 times 1/5 is 1/25. And 25 times 5 is 125. And 125 times 5 is 625. So notice the size of that denominator. So if we go to put it together, 1/5 to the 4th power is 1/625. Wow. But we don't have to just do whole numbers and fractions. We can do decimals as well. Any number is going to work for this. So if I have 6/10 squared, and oftentimes if it's to the 2nd power, we say it's square. It simply means 6/10 times 6/10. And if I go to multiply that, 6/10 times 6/10 is 3/600. So 6/10 squared is 3/600. We can do it with any type of number. Now, a special exponent is the exponent of 0. And I'm not going to go into details why this is, because it takes a while to understand. But I just want you to know that if you have any base to the 0 power, it always equals 1. So 58 to the 0 power equals 1. 45 to the 0 power equals 1. 1,214 to the 0 power equals 1. Anything to the 0 power equals 1. So, sometimes they're going to give you the answer, and they're going to ask you to work backwards and find the exponent. Well, what we do is we use something called factor trees. And every number has like a fingerprint. And the fingerprint is based off of what's called prime factorization. So we need to understand the difference between a prime number and a composite number. So prime numbers only have 2 factors, 1 and themselves. So the only way I can make 2 is 2 times 1. And the only way I can make 3 is 3 times 1. Those are called prime numbers. Composite numbers have more than the 2 factors. So let's take 6. Well, I can make 6 by 1 times 6, or I can make it by 2 times 3. So if you can make it more ways than just 1 in itself, then it's a composite number. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 81 and I'm going to break it down to only prime numbers. And you can choose any numbers to start with, but I think the easiest is to choose 9 times 9. And so I literally start to create a tree with this. And so notice I have this arrow that touches that 81. But I know that 9 is not a prime number. It's a composite number. Because I can make it by 1 times 9, or I can make it 3 times 3. So I can't stop there. I've got to break it down again. So I'm going to make another tree branch, and I'm going to touch the 9, and I think, what two numbers can I multiply together to equal 9? And I know it's 3 times 3. Now, 3's are prime numbers. That means I can stop. But I have to do it to the second 9 as well, and I get 3 times 3. So I can rewrite 81 back into its exponent form by just counting up how many times 3 is repeatedly multiplied. Well, it's multiplied once, twice, 3, 4. So I would write 81 is 3 to the 4th power. So we can go either direction when we're working with exponents. Now, the hardest thing they're going to do is they're going to combine this concept of exponents with order of operations. So they're going to give you an expression. So say I have 4 and 5 tenths times 10 to the 4th power. Well, I have multiple operations there, because I have multiplication there and I have exponents there. And we know, according to order of operation, we have to work our exponent first. So I'm going to take 10 to the 4th power and I'm going to figure out what it is. Well, 10 to the 4th power is repeatedly multiplying 10. So 10 times 10 times 10 times 10, and that equals 10,000. Once I've figured that out and my exponent is gone, now I can multiply it by the 4 and 5 tenths. Now, this is where it's really easy to multiply, because whenever you multiply by a power of 10, all you have to do is count the number of zeros they have, and you move your decimal point to the right that many places, because remember, to multiply, our number gets bigger. So I count 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. So I'm going to start here at my decimal point, and I'm going to move it over once, twice, 3, 4, and where you end up, that's where you put your new decimal point. So in the end, now my decimal point is moved all the way to the end, and I get 45,000. So 4 and 5 tenths times 10 to the 4th power equals 45,000. So there's lots of ways to work with exponents, but that's about all we can do for today. So now it's up to you. Go have some fun with math.